Okay, can I get some change?
Yo, G, they can't stop me from rapping, can they? Can they hop? I spit it through the wire, man. It's too much stuff on my heart right now. Man.
Tiffany Young, Tiffany Young Foundation, we can talk about that. Tiffany, your older sister, phenomenal All-American high school at East Lawrence High School. She was that deal and got a full scholarship to play at Purdue. Mm-hmm. Actually, at the year, July 30th, 31st, they had just won the national championship.
Yeah.
And beat Duke 62-45. Driving
you know
down.
Your stuff.
Oh, yeah, I'm on it. I'm on my research now. And of course, three people in the car, including her boyfriend at that time that was driving, hit by a drunk driver. And I'm just kind of for my audience, give them a little backdrop of who she was and how dynamic she was. I think I read an article, came across an article where they just celebrated like 20 years of that championship. This year before last. And her memory still lives on in a very rich way.
Mm-hmm.
Only 21 years of age. So that is the Tiffany Young legacy, but that's evolved. For you, was the youngest one. You was only 12 years old when this happened. Quickly, take us through how devastating, man, was that passing, and how did your family deal with this? The drunk driver, you hear about that so many times.
Yeah, and I remember, I remember just like it was yesterday, exactly where we were. Me and Nay had went to, and I think about this stuff, I was like, even then God was showing me like how I could recognize stuff. And I didn't think about it until then, but we was at the skating ring, and it was around, not all this stuff I didn't know before, but it was around 9 something, and I was telling Nay, I was like, I'm ready to go. And I literally remember this like it was just saying, she was like, why? Like, we haven't, I was like, I'm just ready to go. I was like, I don't feel right, I'm ready to go. We stayed for a little bit, we left, we get home, my cousins was with us, we go to drop them off. Now it's, by this time it's late, when mom and them usually are in the bed. The lights was on at my cousin's house, nobody was at their house. And we was like, why your mom and them ain't at home? So we took them to our house, which was like literally across the street. Mm-hmm. Our lights was on. And they was like, why the lights on? So we get there, and this is when they didn't have, they was looking through the phone book for flights.
Yes.
So daddy was looking, he was like, Tiffany's been in a bad car accident, and like we have to get to Gary, Indiana, because that's where they were. He was like, we have to get to Gary, Indiana. And even on that trip, mama was like, she just need us. Like when we get there, she just need us. And in the back, I was feeling like, I think she's dead.
Did you say this?
No, I didn't say this. But in my mind, I was feeling like, I think she's dead. Mm. But I never said anything. So we get there, and of course we get there, and they tell us, you know, that she had passed. But she passed at 9, it was like at between 9 and 9:30.
Yes.
During that same time that now I look back on that. But yeah, during like 9:30, and they called my parents them after or whatever. But yeah, she had the car accident, and with me being so young, me and Tiffany was really, really close.
Okay.
Like, she's like my other mom, that I would say she was like my other mom. And I remember the last time she came home, and she would do stuff like this all the time, but it was just different. The last time she came home, she gave mom and them a hug and kiss, all this stuff, and she called me and was like, hey, I just want you to know, just called to say I love you. And I was like, okay, love you too. Didn't think none of it. But she called each person in the family, like just sharing her love or whatever.
Yes.
And like a couple of days later, she ended up passing. So during that time, my mom and them, I will tell you, especially my mom, them are some strong people.
Because
people don't know, like my sister passed. A few months after that, my mom passed. Then my granddaddy, we had my other Kim, she had a daughter that passed at 2 months old.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, like my family been through a whole lot. But my mom and dad, like I would say mommy is the one who keeps everybody super strong. Because I don't remember, except the first time we got there, I remember mama crying. But after that, she was walking down that hospital quoting scriptures, thanking God for the other two she have, and she would just quote scriptures. And that's all I remember. Like mama, she really keep everybody together. But during the process, like they've been so strong, now they real sensitive about their drinking.
I can believe. Yes. I can very much believe
like,
that.
Even in our family, I think it's so cool because they know. And everybody really respects the fact, we don't drink, you know, nobody drinks around them or whatever, because it's just a sensitive thing. Yeah, and I think people would never understand unless, even though you'd be like, okay, well, they're just wine or something, but you have to understand, like, this was something that, that killed, you know, somebody very close to us, but they have dealt with it, like, more ways than, I mean, I don't know if I would be, would have been able to deal with it like that if it was my daughter, and my daddy did the eulogy. Preached the eulogy.
Now, I know that, and quickly, I want to get to the foundation, but I know that also the drunk driver actually survived. Got put in lock. Of course, I'm sure he probably still in prison, or maybe just got out or whatever.
No, he actually got out within like three years, I think.
Oh.
Yeah. So. It was another thing.
Hurdle.
Yeah. Yes. Like, I remember going, we were sitting in the room, because they have to show you, like, the pictures of everything. Like, I think she had two broke arms, both her legs was broke, her chest was crushed. Like, they have to tell you everything. So, I feel like, and I could be wrong, even if she would have lived, I feel like she would have been like a complete vegetable because all the stuff they were saying. But he sat in there and he told them, I'm sorry. He told us, I'm sorry about your loss, but I got kids too that I have to take care of. He was in the military. He said, I got kids that I have to take care of. That is what he told us in the courtroom. And I think he got, they said he had 7 years, but he ended up, he ended up maybe doing like two or three.
Good behavior.
Got out. Hit somebody else.
Oh.
Went back to prison, got back out, and killed somebody. Again, drinking and driving.
Oh.
Yeah.
My Lord. Also, he's a, okay.
So in then the they was like, well,
maybe we made a mistake.
Do something. Yeah, it was crazy. But that little bit, and daddy still to this day, like, I remember him going up there, and he shook his hand, and he said, I forgive you.
Mm.
Yeah.
That's strong. That's a lot of strength. That's a whole other conversation. Forgiveness is a life coach and all that.